Come to order. I ask everyone present to please rise and recite with me the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
With us today to offer an invocation is Reverend Dale Jensen, who is the senior pastor at Saratoga Abundant Life Church in Saratoga Springs.
Can we pray? Almighty God, we pray that your hand would be upon this Senate assembly. I pray your blessing upon each individual senator. Lord, I know all the decisions that need to be made here are beyond any human understanding, so I ask that you would grace every single senator with the ability to see the right and the truth and the things that are best for this state. Lord, I pray for great counsel for each one of the senators. Lord, I know counsel makes a difference in any one of our lives, so I pray for great counselors in each one of their lives. Lord, I pray for their spouses. I pray a blessing over their spouses as they give their time and their energy to the state. I pray, God, that you put peace in their homes. I pray, Father, for their children. I pray, God, a blessing and a protection for their whole family. And Lord, I pray that for every single senator in this place, they might sense your presence, they might sense your awareness, and they might sense your grace to fill every need that they have. And I pray it in Jesus' name. Amen.
Reading of the journal. Secretary will read.
In Senate, Sunday, June 2nd, the Senate met pursuant to adjournment. The journal is Saturday, June 1st, is read and approved on motion, Senate adjourned.
Without objection, the journal stands approved as read. Presentation of petitions, messages from the Assembly, messages from the Governor, reports of standing committees, reports of select committees, communications and reports from state officers, motions and resolutions. Senator Libous.
President, I believe there's a resolution previously adopted at the desk, number 301 by Senator DeFrancisco. It was adopted on January 29th. Could you please read it in its entirety and then call on Senator DeFrancisco?
The Secretary will read.
Legislative Resolution number 301 by Senator DeFrancisco, congratulating the CNY United Power Soccer Team upon the occasion of winning the 2012 National Power Soccer Tournament. Whereas, excellence in competitive team sports is achieved only through strenuous practice, determination, and strategic planning, nurtured by dedicated coaching. And whereas, the people of the state of New York take great pride in honoring those talented individuals who distinguish themselves and their community through outstanding team spirit, character, and athletic performance. And whereas, attentive to such concern and in full accord with its long-standing traditions, this legislative body is justly proud to hereby recognize and congratulate the CNY United upon the occasion of winning the 2012 National Power Soccer Tournament. And whereas CNY United, a power soccer team in Central New York, was founded in 2005, the 2012 team was comprised of these members: Andrew Cunningham, Ryan Charbonneau, Tony Reuter, Peyton Sefik, Hunter Schaefer, Hallie Weilen, Morgan Reeks, Helena Schmidt, Sarah Hamlin, and Anthony Garino. And whereas power soccer, which is played by athletes in motorized wheelchairs, requires a great deal of teamwork, court sense, patience, vision, and timing. And whereas after months of rigorous practice and travel for out-of-state competitions, CNY United qualified for the 2012 National Power Soccer Tournament, which was held in Fort Wayne, Indiana on July 15, 2012. And whereas CNY United finished 4 wins, 0 losses, 1 tie, in the 2012 National Power Soccer Tournament after beating the home team of Fort Wayne with a score of 3-1 during the tournament's championship game. And whereas CNY United prevailed victorious during the 2012 National Power Soccer Tournament due to the unbeatable combination of outstanding talent, sportsmanship, team effort, and perseverance. And whereas the notable efforts displayed by CNY United are due in great part to the dedicated forces of head coach Jim Sefik and assistant coach Tom Cunningham, along with equipment manager Ken Keppel, Mark Charbonneau, and Alice Sefik. And whereas members of CNY United have also received a loyal support of family, friends, and community at large throughout the entire season, now therefore be it resolved that this legislative body pause in its deliberations to recognize and congratulate the CNY United upon the occasion of winning the 2012 National Power Soccer Tournament, The travel team members are Andrew Cunningham, Ryan Charbonneau, Tony Reuter, and Payne Sefik. And be it further resolved that copies of this resolution suitably engrossed be transmitted to the athletes and coaches of CNY United.
Senator DeFrancisco on the previously adopted resolution.
Thank you. I'm pleased to welcome the great national champion, CNY United Power Soccer Team. And they're right here by the clock with their great coach, Jim Sefik, and some of the relatives are up in the gallery proudly watching their team today in this Senate chambers. This team has gone all over the country to play power soccer, and they were successful in winning the national championship, but that's not something any of you would be surprised about, because we win national championships in Central New York all the time. This is just another one in the long line of national championships that we are responsible for. We're really proud of all of you. It was a wonderful effort, and I've gone to a practice. I wouldn't get in one of those chairs because some of these guys are ruthless. They're banging the chairs against each other. I was afraid I was going to get hurt on the sidelines. So this is not this is a contact sport, believe me. So we welcome you all here today, congratulate you, and best of success in the future. Thank you.
Congratulations to the members of the Central New York United Power Soccer Team on the occasion of winning the national championship, and we welcome you here to Albany and hope you enjoy your day. Senator Libous.
Thank you, Mr. President. I believe Senator Gennaris and Senator Carlucci both have motions, so however you...
Very good. Senator Gennaris.
Thank you, Mr. President. On behalf of Senator Latimer, on page 27, I offer the following amendments to calendar 231, Senate print 2122, and ask that said bill retain its place on third reading calendar.
The amendments are received. The bill will retain its place on the third reading calendar. Senator Carlucci.
Mr. President, I wish to call up your bill, print number 2170, recalled from the Assembly, which is now at the desk.
Secretary will read.
Calendar number 180 by Senator Valesky, Senate print 2170, enact amend the environmental conservation law.
Senator Carlucci.
Mr. President, I now move to reconsider the vote by which this bill was passed.
The Secretary will call the roll on reconsideration.
Adam C. Francisco, Libous, Klein, Skelos, Stewart, Cousins, Zeldin, ayes 59.
Senator Carlucci.
Mr. President, I now offer the following amendments.
The amendments are received. Senator Libous.
On behalf of Senator Martins, Mr. President, page 46, I offer the following amendments to calendar number 662, Senate print 1987. Ask that said bill retain its place in the third reading calendar.
Amendments are received.
On behalf of Senator Golden, I call up his bill 3754, recalled from the Assembly, which is now at the desk.
Secretary will read.
Calendar number 175 by Senator Golden, Senate print 3754, enact amend the public housing law.
Senator Libous.
I now move to reconsider the vote by which this bill was passed.
Secretary will call the roll on reconsideration.
Adam C. Francisco, Libous, Klein, Skelos, Stewart, Cousins, Zeldin, ayes 60.
Senator Libous.
Mr. President, I offer up the following amendments.
Amendments are received.
On behalf of Senator Griffo, Mr. President, I call up his bill 2233, recalled from the Assembly, which is now at the desk.
Secretary will read.
Calendar number 267 by Senator Griffo, Senate print 2233, enact amend the state technology law.
Senator Libous.
I move to reconsider the vote by which this bill is passed.
Secretary will call the roll on reconsideration.
Adam C. Francisco, Libous, Klein, Skelos, Stewart, Cousins, Zeldin, ayes 60.
Senator Libous. Mr. President, I now offer up the following amendments.
Those amendments are received.
Mr. President, on behalf of Senator Young, I call up her bill, Senate print 3923A. Recalled from the Assembly, which is now at the desk.
Secretary will read.
Calendar number 340 by Senator Young, Senate print 3923A, enact amend the highway law.
Senator Libous.
Mr. President, I now move to reconsider the vote by which this bill is passed.
Secretary will call the roll on reconsideration.
Adam C. Francisco, Libous, Klein, Skelos, Stewart, Cousins, Zeldin, ayes 60.
Senator Libous.
Mr. President, I offer up the following amendments.
Amendments are received.
On behalf of Senator Golden, I call up his bill 4422A, recalled from the Assembly, now at the desk.
Secretary will read.
Calendar number 418 by Senator Golden, Senate print 4422A, enact Act, amend the executive law.
Senator Libous.
Mr. President, I move to reconsider the vote by which this bill was passed.
Secretary will call the roll on reconsideration.
Adams, E. Francisco, Libous, Klein, Skelos, Stewart, Cousins, Zeldin, I 60.
Senator Libous.
Mr. President, I offer up the following amendments.
Those amendments are received.
Mr. President, on behalf of Senator Maziers, I wish to call up as print 1122, recall from the assembly, which is now at the desk.
Secretary will read.
Calendar number 573 by Senator Maziar, Senate Print 1122, enact amend the public officers law.
Senator Libous. President, I now move to reconsider the vote by which this bill is passed.
Secretary will call the roll on reconsideration.
Adams, E. Francisco, Libous, Klein, Skelos, Stewart, Cousins, Zeldin, I 60.
Mr. President, I offer up the following amendments.
The amendments are received.
Thank you, Mr. President, and I have a number of amendments to make here. Let me start, Mr. President. Amendments I want to offer to the following third reading calendar bills. The first one is on behalf of Senator Ritchie, page 34, calendar 407, Senate print 4302. On behalf of Senator Zeldin, page 38, calendar 490, Senate print 4132A. On behalf of Senator Lavelle, page 44, calendar 617, Senate print 2006. On behalf of Senator Gallivan, page 23, calendar 74, Senate print 583C. On behalf of Senator Felder, page 44, calendar 624, Senate print 4529A. On behalf of Senator Felder, page 45, calendar 644, and Senate print 4880. And the most important one, on behalf of Senator Libous, on page 27, that was a joke. I just wondered if everybody was listening. On page 27, calendar 208, 4191A, Mr. President, I now move that these bills retain their place on the third reading calendar, please.
All amendments have been received. All bills shall retain their place on the third reading calendar.
Mr. President, I believe members will about to take their seats so that we could have order in the chamber, and we will now do the reading of the non-controversial calendar.
I'd ask all senators to be seated so that we may proceed with the non-controversial reading of today's calendar. Secretary will read.
Calendar number 36 by Senator Bonasek, Senate print 1884, enact amend the environmental conservation law.
Read the last section.
Section 2 of this act should take effect on the 1st of July.
Call the roll.
Adams, E. Francisco, Libous, Klein, Skelos, Stewart, Cousins, Zeldin.
Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 36, those recorded in the negative are Senators Espaillat, Gibson, Hassel-Thompson, Hoylman, Krueger, Marcelino, Rivera, Sanders, Serrano, Stavisky, and Kachik. Ayes 50, nays 11.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 102 by Senator Maziar, Senate print 3806C, enact amend the energy law.
Read the last section.
Section 4 of this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adams, E. Francisco, Libous, Klein, Skelos, Stewart, Cousins, Zeldin. Aye, 60, nays 1. Senator Espaillat recorded in the negative.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 148 by Senator Larkin, Senate print 274A, enact amend the retirement Social Security law.
Read the last section.
Section 2 of this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adams, E. Francisco, Libous, Klein, Skelos, Stewart, Cousins, Zeldin. Aye, 61.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 284 by Senator Lavelle, Senate print 3059B, enact amend the environmental conservation law.
Read the last section.
Section 2 of this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adams, E. Francisco, Libous, Klein, Skelos, Stewart, Cousins, Zeldin. In relation to calendar Kennedy. Relation to calendar 284, those recorded in the negative are Senators Espaillat, Gibson, Kennedy, and Serrano. Ayes 57, nays 4.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 318 by Senator LaValle, Senate print 1555, an act amending the education law.
Read the last section.
Section 2 of this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adam C. Francisco, Libous, Klein, Skelos, Stewart, Cousins, Zeldin. Ayes 62.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 326 by Senator Klein, Senate print 2369A, an act amend the local finance law.
Read the last section.
Section 4 of this act should take effect January 1, 2014.
Call the roll.
Adam C. Francisco, Libous, Klein, Skelos, Stewart, Cousins, Zeldin. Aye, 62.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 327 by Senator Zeldin, Senate print 2925B, an act to authorize.
Read the last section.
Section 2 of this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adam C. Francisco, Libous, Klein, Skelos, Stewart, Cousins, Zeldin. In relation to calendar 327, those recorded in the negative are Senators Banasek, Larkin, and O'Mara. Ayes 59, nays 3.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 331 by Senator Griffo, Senate print 4122, enacted in relation to.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adam C. Francisco, Libous, Klein, Skelos, Stewart, Cousins, Zeldin. Ayes 61, nays 1. Senator Krueger, recorded in the negative.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 338 by Senator Nozzolio, Senate print 3298A, an act to amend the vehicle and traffic law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect on the 180th day.
Call the roll.
Adam C. Francisco, Libous, Klein, Skelos, Stewart, Cousins, Zeldin. Ayes 61, nays 1. Senator Gibson, recorded in the negative.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 367 by Senator Ball, Senate print 2801, an act to amend the election law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect on the 180th day.
Call the roll.
Adam C. Francisco, Libous, Klein, Skelos, Stewart, Cousins, Zeldin.
Senator Gianaris to explain his vote.
This bill purports to allow people to register to vote while applying for a hunting or fishing license. I'm certainly not against allowing people easier access to voter registration. The reason I'm voting in the negative on this bill is for two reasons. Number one, I have legislation that will open up interactions with every state agency to applications for voter registration, not just to a select few that may cater to a certain constituency and not others. And I think a uniform approach would be better served. The second reason is because it's my understanding that some of these licenses are available from private entities. And I think the idea that we would allow people to register to vote with non-governmental entities, with employees who may not be trained in how to properly handle or help people register to vote, is problematic on many levels. So for those reasons, I'll be voting in the negative.
Senator Gianaris to be recorded in the negative. Senator Krueger, do you wish to explain your vote?
Thank you. I certainly share Senator Gianaris' concerns. I would highlight, if this bill ensured that voter registration was taken with licenses for hunting and fishing only through government offices, I would have no problem with it. But it actually sets up a scenario where over 1,400 retail sites would actually be required to accept voter registration, and again, as I believe was said, and their employees required to assist. And so I am a strong believer in simplifying voter registration anywhere and everywhere, but I don't actually think we should have an unfunded mandate on private companies and their employees to have to do government's work. So I'll be voting no, Mr. President. Thank you.
Senator Krueger, to be recorded in the negative, announce the results.
In relation to calendar 367, those recorded in the negative are Senators Avella, Gianaris, Hoylman, Krueger, Montgomery, Parker, Rivera, Serrano, and Stavisky. Ayes 53, nays 9.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 406 by Senator Ritchie, Senate print 4299A, an act to amend the Agriculture and Markets Law.
Read the last section.
Section 6, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adam C. Francisco, Libous, Klein, Skelos, Stewart, Cousins, Zeldin. Ayes 61, nays 1. Senator Espaillat recorded in the negative. The
bill is passed.
Calendar number 408 by Senator Gallivan, Senate print 96, an act to amend the executive law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adam C. Francisco, Libous, Klein, Skelos, Stewart, Cousins, Zeldin. Ayes 62.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 434 by Senator Carlucci, Senate print 3280.
Bill is laid aside.
Calendar number 439 by Senator Fuchillo, Senate print 774A, enact amend the general business law.
Read the last section.
Section 2 of the statute will take effect on the 30th day.
Call the roll.
Adam C. Francisco, Livis, Klein, Skelos, Stewart, Cousins, Zeldin. Aye 61, nays 1, Senator.
This is calendar 439.
Aye 62.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 462 by Senator Seward, Senate print 3563, enact amend the environmental conservation law.
Read the last section.
Section 2 of this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adam C. Francisco, Livis, Klein, Skelos, Stewart, Cousins, Zeldin.
Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 462, those recorded in the negative are Senators Adams, Espaillat, Gianaris, Gibson, Hassel-Thompson, Hoylman, Kennedy, Krueger, Montgomery, Parker, Rivera, Sanders, Serrano, and Stavisky. Ayes 48, nays 14.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 465 by Senator Young, Senate print 4356, enact amend the Soil and Water Conservation Districts Law.
Read the last section.
Section 2 of this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adam C. Francisco, Livis, Klein, Skelos, Stewart, Cousins, Zeldin. Aye 62.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 479 by Senator Hannan, Senate print 4414, enact to amend the Public Health Law.
Read the last section.
Section 3 of this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adam C. Francisco, Livis, Klein, Skelos, Stewart, Cousins, Zeldin. Aye 63.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 485 by Senator Maziar, Senate print 1063, enact amend the county law.
Read the last section.
Section 2 of this act should take effect on the 180th day.
Call the roll.
Adam C. Francisco, Livis, Klein, Skelos, Stewart, Cousins, Zeldin. Aye 63.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 506 by Senator Griffel, Senate print 3494, enact amend the highway law.
Read the last section.
Section 3 of this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adam C. Francisco, Livis, Klein, Skelos, Stewart, Cousins, Zeldin. Aye 63.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 553 by Senator Ball, Senate print 2306, enact amend the executive law.
Read the last section.
Section 2 of this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adam C. Francisco, Livis, Klein, Skelos, Stewart, Cousins, Zeldin. Aye 63.
The bill is passed.
In relation to calendar 553, aye 62, nays 1, Senator Montgomery recorded in the negative.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 556 by Senator Seward, Senate print 2895, enact amend the insurance law.
Read the last section.
Section 3 of this act should take effect January 1, 2014.
Call the roll.
Adam C. Francisco, Livis, Klein, Skelos, Stewart, Cousins, Zeldin. Relation to calendar 556, those recorded in the negative are Senators Gibson, Hoylman, Krueger, Montgomery, Perkins, and Sanders. Ayes 57, nays 6.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 567 by Senator Avella, Senate print 4544B, enact amend the environmental conservation law.
Read the last section.
Section 2 of this act should take effect on the 120th day.
Call the roll.
Adam C. Francisco, Livis, Klein, Skelos, Stewart, Cousins, Zeldin. Aye 63.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 583 by Senator DeFrancisco, Senate print 553B, Enact amend the real property tax law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adams, DeFrancisco, Libous, Klein, Skelos, Stewart, Cousins, Zeldin. Aye, 63.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 584 by Senator Hannan, Senate Print 3476A, an act authorizing.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adams, DeFrancisco, Libous, Klein, Skelos, Stewart, Cousins, Zeldin. Aye, 62, nays 1, Senator Bonasek, recorded in the negative.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 648 by Senator Bonasek, Senate Print 1876A, enact amend the county law.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adams, DeFrancisco, Libous, Klein, Skelos, Stewart, Cousins, Zeldin. Aye. Aye, 62, nays 1, Senator Krueger, recorded in the negative.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 649 by Senator Klein, Senate Print 2438, enact amend the Agriculture and Markets Law.
Read the last section.
Section 6, this act should take effect on the 1st of January.
Call the roll.
Adams, DeFrancisco, Libous, Klein, Skelos, Stewart, Cousins, Zeldin. Aye, 63.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 658 by Senator Grisanti, Senate Print 1604. Enact amend the labor law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adams, DeFrancisco, Libous, Klein, Skelos, Stewart, Cousins, Zeldin. Aye, 61, nays 2, Senators DeFrancisco and Gibson, recorded in the negative.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 678 by Senator Fuchillo, Senate Print 739. Enact amend the vehicle and traffic law.
Read the last section.
Section 4, this act should take effect on the 90th day.
Call the roll.
Adams, DeFrancisco, Libous, Klein, Skelos, Stewart, Cousins, Zeldin.
And Montgomery.
Ayes 59, nays 4, Senators Hassel Thompson, Montgomery, Parker, and Perkins, recorded in the negative.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 730 by Senator Addabbo, Senate Print 3740, enact amend the penal law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect on the 1st of November.
Call the roll.
Adams, DeFrancisco, Libous, Klein, Skelos, Stewart, Cousins, Zeldin.
Senator DeFrancisco to explain his vote.
Yes, I'm going to vote no, not because I want to allow people to falsely solicit donations. My only point is the law as it exists right now already prohibits that type of activity. If you look at the sentence above, the new sentence in the bill, engages in a scheme constituting a systematic ongoing course of conduct with intent to defraud more than one person or persons. And it goes on. And I just simply believe, from a technical standpoint, falsely soliciting donations fits in that broad definition. So that's the reason I'm voting no.
Senator DeFrancisco to be recorded in the negative. Announce the results.
Aye, 62, nays 1, Senator DeFrancisco, recorded in the negative.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 753 by Senator Young, Senate Print 2679A, enact amend the general municipal law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adams, DeFrancisco, Libous, Klein, Skelos, Stewart, Cousins, Zeldin. Aye, 63.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 804 by Senator Serrano, Senate Print 918, enact amend the Parks, Recreation, and Historic Preservation Law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adams, DeFrancisco, Libous, Klein, Skelos, Stewart, Cousins, Zeldin. Aye, 63.
The bill is passed. Senator Libous, that completes the non-controversial reading of the calendar.
You do the controversial reading?
Secretary will ring the bells. Secretary will read.
Calendar number 434 by Senator Carlucci, Senate Print 3280, enact amend the mental hygiene law.
Senator Stavisky.
Explanation, please.
Senator Carlucci, an explanation has been requested by Senator Stavisky.
Thank you. This piece of legislation is an important piece of legislation to really bring the mental hygiene law into the 21st century, give much needed flexibility to hospitals to make sure that when it is needed to to admit someone to a psychiatric center, that a nurse practitioner, a psychiatric nurse practitioner acting within their scope can do that. A psychiatric nurse practitioner already has the ability to diagnose, to treat, to prescribe atypical antipsychotic medications. So this is adding flexibility, bringing the law into the 21st century, and that's it. Thank you.
Senator Savisky.
Will the senator yield?
Senator Carlucci, do you yield?
Yes.
Sponsor yields.
Mr. President, through you, this was a product of the Committee on Mental Health and Developmental Disabilities, and yet much of the bill pertains to the scope of practice. Shouldn't this have been heard by the Committee on Higher Education?
Mr. President, this bill only amends mental hygiene law. It does not change the scope of practice. This is fully allowing nurse practitioners to act within their scope of practice.
The senator would continue to yield.
Senator Carlucci?
Yes.
Sponsor yields.
What is the current process for voluntary and involuntary commitment of patients?
The current process for voluntary and involuntary admission is that a physician, psychiatrist, 99% of the time, would have to submit a medical certification. Therefore, then the director of the facility where they're being submitted would have to have another physician examine that patient to determine what their need is, to keep them on an involuntary basis.
The senator would continue to yield.
Senator Carlucci? You continue
yes.
to yield? The sponsor yields.
If the person, and I'm not talking about a voluntary commitment because I think that's a totally different issue. I'm talking about the involuntary commitment. Generally, wouldn't you agree that patients are taken to the emergency room?
Mr. President, yes, in many cases, there's situations where people are going to emergency rooms, and this is where we need that flexibility to make sure that we have quality patient care. We've seen a decrease in the level of psychiatrists around the state, and that's why we want to make sure that these psychiatric nurse practitioners that are acting in their scope have that ability to admit someone so they're not just staying in an emergency room for an unduly amount of time.
If the senator would continue to yield.
Senator Carlucci?
Yes.
Sponsor yields.
If they are taken to the emergency room, generally the emergency rooms have two psychiatrists available because there are two psychiatrists are required for the commitment proceedings. Is that correct?
Well, that would be the process that we would need to the two physicians to sign off to admit them. However, this is filling the need where there in the cases where there are not two psychiatrists on staff.
The senator would continue to yield.
Senator Carlucci, do you continue to yield?
Yes.
Sponsor yields.
If this bill were enacted and a nurse practitioner can sign the necessary papers to for an involuntary commitment, aren't you opening up that institution and the healthcare professionals to grounds for a legal challenge on taking away someone's civil rights? In other words, a civil commitment is a very serious proceeding, and there have been statutes and court cases involving the whole civil involving the entire civil commitment proceedings.
Yeah, I would disagree with that. This does not change the scope of practice for the nurse practitioner. It still has the safeguards for the adequacy of counsel. The hearings that would be involved are still in place. And this law does nothing to change that, to make sure that those safeguards are in place.
If the senator would continue to yield.
Senator Carlucci.
Yes.
Sponsor continues to yield.
That wasn't my question. My question was, you're changing the whole civil commitment proceeding and opening both the healthcare professionals and the institution to a court case.
No, I would disagree with that. This does not change the proceeding. It does one simple change to the mental hygiene law in allowing nurse practitioners to act within their full scope of practice.
One last question.
Senator Carlucci?
I yield.
Sponsor yields.
What exactly can the nurse practitioner do in terms of diagnosis?
Well, right here, I have the law in front of me. The practice of registered professionals nursing by a nurse practitioner certified under Section 6910 of this article may include the diagnosis of illness and physical conditions and the performance of therapeutic and corrective measures within the specialty area of practice in collaboration with a licensed physician qualified to collaborate in the specialty involved.
There's a lot of diagnoses like there aren't any other.
I'm sorry, then there's one more question I have.
Senator Carlucci, do you yield?
Yes. Sponsor.
It says in collaboration with a licensed psychiatrist. But if you've got a licensed psychiatrist, why do you need the nurse practitioner?
Right, and you're exactly right. This does not change the licensed physician qualified to collaborate. It doesn't change that at all. What this does is add flexibility in the cases where we have statistics that show a decrease in acting psychiatrists in New York State, and where we do not have two psychiatrists on staff at an ER particularly, this bill would be very helpful in that case to deliver quality care that New Yorkers deserve.
Thank you, Senator Carlucci, for your explanation. On the bill, Mr. President.
Senator Stavisky, on the bill.
Yes. The words "in collaboration" are part of the statute, and if the psychiatrists are there to offer the collaboration, because you can't have a psychiatrist in Buffalo collaborating with a nurse practitioner in Riverhead. Therefore, seems to me that you are creating a potential problem. I think when you take away somebody's civil rights and involuntarily commit that individual to a hospital, that is a very serious proceeding, and I think it should require the two psychiatrists. I have no problem with the involuntary commitment, but I have a great problem with the, I'm sorry, I have no problem with a voluntary commitment, but I have a serious problem with the involuntary commitment. I vote no.
Senator Hannan.
Thank you, Mr. President. Senator Carlucci. I'm not going to ask you questions, but I have some doubts about this, not from your committee standpoint, health, but rather from health, because we're dealing with the nurse practitioners. We're dealing with the nurse practitioners, and we've been really looking at how to expand folks who are auxiliary parts, but necessary parts and important parts of the healthcare system, dealing with physicians, assistants, and nurse practitioners. And when it came down to examination, it's been, I've been tangentially or related to this discussion from the Health Committee. I know it's been going on in the Higher Education Committee, and usually when we're dealing with scope of practice, they primarily go through higher education. Part of the discussion I've been involved with and have been with a number of the units of physician practices or organized medicine, not necessarily just the medical society, but internists or family practitioners or primary care practitioners, has been the greater involvement of nurse practitioners. But there are nurse practitioners and there are nurse practitioners. Some of them have just graduated, and some of them have been practicing for a number of years. Some of them are qualified to do things to stand in the stead of the physician that they're assisting or they're working in collaboration with. And some of them are not there yet. And I think when you start to marry the policies that are embodied in this bill, which would be the qualifications of the nurse practitioner and the questions of regard to psychiatric judgments and questions of regard to being committed. I think we need to take another look at this and try to figure out how there could be a greater compromise. So, I mean, I think people have some doubts because of other discussions, namely in the medical field, but I have doubts and think that we should go back and take a longer look at this and leave this for another day.
Thank you, Senator Hannan. Senator Rivera.
Mr. President, the sponsor with you for a few questions.
Senator Carlucci, do you yield? Sponsor yields.
Thank you. Through you, Mr. President. Could the sponsor tell me how he defines scope of practice?
Well, practice is defined in the law, and that's how I would define it, what it's specified in education law.
Through you, Mr. President, if the sponsor would continue to yield.
Yes.
Do you have that, through you, Mr. President, do you have that definition available by any chance?
Yes, I do.
Through you, Mr. President, if the sponsor would continue.
Senator Carlucci, do you yield?
Yes.
Sponsor continues to yield.
Thank you, Mr. President. So through you, what is that definition?
The definition that I have in front of me is what I read previously, is diagnosis of illness and physical conditions and the performance of therapeutic and corrective measures within a specialty area of practice in collaboration with a licensed physician qualified to collaborate in the specialty involved, provided such services are performed in accordance with written practice agreement and written practice protocols.
Through you, Mr. President, the
sponsor. And that's just part of the scope. As we talked about before, really when we talk about psychiatric nurse practitioners, the ability to treat, diagnose, and prescribe.
Through you, Mr. President, the sponsor would continue.
Senator Carlucci, do you yield?
Yes.
Sponsor yields.
Thank you, Mr. President. Through you. I was unclear in my earlier question. I was not referring in particular to the scope of practice of nurse practitioners. My question through you, Mr. President, would be how you define the concept of scope of practice, regardless of what we're talking about, doctors, nurse practitioners, or any other person.
Well, I would say to make it as short as possible, the definition of law that gives them the criteria to act within that profession.
Through you, Mr. President, if the sponsor would continue to yield.
Senator Carlucci.
Yes.
Sponsor yields.
Thank you, Mr. President. So if we're saying that we're talking about procedures, action, and processes that are permitted under the law for a particular licensed individual, how is the bill in front of us not a scope of practice bill as it relates to nurse practitioners?
This bill is allowing nurse practitioners to fully act within their scope of practice. This is changing mental hygiene law, not changing their scope of practice in the education law. The simple change to bring it into the 21st century and allow nurse practitioners to admit on a voluntary or involuntary basis.
Thank you, Mr. President, on the bill.
Senator Rivera, on the bill.
Thank you, Mr. President. I thank the sponsor for answering some of the questions. When I'm referring to scope of practice in particular, we might be talking about 19th, 20th, or 21st century. What we're talking about is the actions, the procedures, and the processes that somebody can perform. So I have to agree with my colleague, Senator Stavisky, when pointing out that this bill actually changes the way that nurse practitioners can actually do their job. It actually expands their ability to do something. Therefore, it is something that should have been considered in the Higher Education Committee. That's number one. Number two, what we're talking about here, and I also have to agree with Senator Stavisky, is a very specific and is a very specific action that has to do with the involuntary, putting somebody in a psychiatric hospital involuntarily. That is something that is that matter of fact, the conversation that we were having earlier, and I want to say Senator Sanders was the one that shared this with me, and I could not agree with him more. We should be talking about how to not lower the standards for such an action, but actually make sure that we hold them to where they are right now, since we're talking about a very serious action that a medical practitioner will take. And lastly, I would also agree with Senator Hannan that when we're talking about what nurse practitioners can and cannot do, certainly we should be talking within it within the health department. I have to say that even though I don't question that there are many that we might need more professionals to be able to do this type of work, I do not agree, even though they are nurse practitioners are highly skilled individuals, I do not believe that they are that we should expand their ability to be able to do this particular thing. So I will be voting in the negative in this piece of legislation. Thank you so much, Mr. President.
Senator Carlucci.
President, after listening to the consideration or the concerns of my colleagues, I'd like to lay this bill aside for the day and work with my colleagues to find out how we can make this bill, what it's intending to do to move these laws into the 21st century, give that flexibility that's needed. So I'll lay the bill aside for the day.
The bill is laid aside for the day. Senator Libous, that completes the controversial reading of the calendar.
I believe that in consultation with the there's no consultation. Senator Klein and Senator Skelos, there'll be a hand up coming up to the desk. President.
The hand up is received. Senator Libous.
Is there any further business at the desk?
There is no further business at the desk.
All right. I move that the being no further business at the Senate will adjourn until tomorrow, Tuesday, June 4th at 3 p.m.
On motion, the Senate stands adjourned until Tuesday, June 4th at 3 p.m.